Hey, a topic somebody asked me to talk about. What is the most romantic thing? Oh, what a sweet topic. What's the most romantic moment in comics? The storyline, the character, the history. What is in my mind the most romantic moment to come out? The love in comics. It's a you know, it's funny is it took me a while. I had this gut response, which I'll tell you, and then I really had to think about it over and over and over. I really had to think about what is this kind of love interest romantic moment that I remember, because there first off, there's not many. It's interesting because comic storylines have gone for, in many cases, the cheap kill, the cheap death, you know, the rebirth, kind of these storylines, but they don't normally go for romance. And they'll do things like having a love interest, you know, the Peter Parker, Black Cat or Mary Jane, Gwen Stacy, kind of Peter's tangled love life and so on. But it's more unusual to have kind of a sweet kind of romance in comics. And funny, in some ways, I think that's funny. It's odd because if you're going for cheap emotional pulls and you're trying to get a new audience, then it seems like that kind of romance, that kind of, you know, you'll shudder when I say this, but the whole Twilight kind of star-crossed lovers thing is it just seems like they haven't gone to the well nearly as much with that as they have with other ploys. And not that I want them to, not that I think that's something that, you know, we desperately need, but you know, it's surprising to me. So there's been lots of things. We've seen the relationship of Lois and Clark. I do think that when we returned and we had you know, the family of Jonathan and Clark and Lois through Convergence and then kind of making their way back into the DC proper, I thought that was very sweet. I liked the you know, the Peter Parker, Mary Jane and daughter, you know, one more day, spin out that whole storyline, renew your vows. Those comics, I like relationships in comics. I like that we have some single characters, we have some ones in relationships. I like it when characters get married, where they stay single. I like that whole dynamic. I do dislike the era that you know, Joe seemed to bring in of that stuff doesn't sell, let's get that stuff out of comics and kind of keep Peter perpetually a, you know, a loser. That's what people want to see most, the bad Parker luck. I think that's said from somebody who really, I mean, bluntly, doesn't understand the character nearly as well as he thinks he does. Because that topic has been gone over to death. That probably I should go over that topic at some point. But no, so I'm going to give an odd one. So my gut answer, the one that struck out in my mind kind of right away, is one that's probably surprising to you. And it's one that I after thinking through all the different, you know, Canary and Green Arrow and Hal and Carol and Carol and Rhodey and Jessica Jones and Luke Cage and just all these different, you know, Scott and Jean, Logan and Jean, probably somebody else and Jean, I don't know, Scott and Maddie, Logan and everybody. There's been lots of romance. The one that, for whatever reason, strikes me is Rain Sinclair and Doug Ramsey. And you, right now, you may be going, "What?" But that there was something about the way that Claremont wrote those characters in New Mutants, and Doug trying to prove himself on the team and having a pretty amazing power, but also not an attack power, not a offensive power, and Rain being kind of this traumatized kid coming up from her religious past and then very shy and then turning into a werewolf kind of demon type, you know, I mean, from her standpoint, it's kind of wolf creature and just that dynamic and the way those characters slowly came together and you know, and wanting to have a relationship and then all the different things. I mean, briefly we had kind of Kitty Pryde in the mix, and then we had that kind of it felt like a very natural friendship and romance, and there's an aspect to that pairing that was just it felt very it stand out in my mind. It's good writing. It's stuck in my mind. And further, when Doug was shot and killed during Fall of the Mutants, and Rain kind of heartbroken because they really had just kind of started to come to more realization with each other around that time. It was a powerful death. It was a death that they eventually, you know, drug up Doug from the grave again, because that's what they do. And Warlock had bonded with him, so they'd opened the door for the character to come back, but not as he was, and never as he would be again. But there was that storyline that it was very powerful for me. So in terms of romance, what's the romance moment I remember most? I mean, there's been tons. That's the one that for me was kind of a very classic, very notable kind of romance. I'm definitely obscure. I doubt there's all of 5 people on the planet who remember that stuff as fondly as I do, but there was a definite, you know, and this is why, this is my opinion. I'm not trying to convince everyone this is the best romance in all of comics. This is the one that stuck out for me. And I think this is the beauty of comics, because everyone, when a writer or a moment catches you, in many cases, it will catch you and you alone. You'll have some moment in the comics. You'll have some relationship or some pairing or some event or some statement, some final ground that a character does that will stick in your mind and be one of those things you carry with you for decades. It's the power of comics. And it doesn't have to conform. In many cases, won't conform to what many others believe and think. It will be yours and yours alone, or at least yours and not many other people. But the whole way the characters were drawn, and the, you know, uneasy kind of pairing, and you really got, there's a depth of the characters. Unfortunately, that stuff got, you know, one of the things that I didn't like about Peter David's run that came later on X-Factor, and what they did with Rain, is kind of made her this kind of perpetually horny character who was, you know, in heat and all the rest. They scrubbed a lot of what made that character kind of so unique and so different. And New Mutants as a title was very rich with deep characters and deep moments and things that you weren't getting into other comics. And that's one part of the reason why the whole mutant line of titles, why Claremont was so successful, is because the characters were not carbon copies of each other, and you had very, very touching moments. You know, a close second for me, same writer, is the whole Forge Storm relationship, which, you know, they bond, they form a relationship. It comes out that Forge designed the gun that stripped Storm's powers, and so there's a bitterness that crept in there, and then kind of this coming together again during Fall of the Mutants. So yeah, Fall of the Mutants was a hell of a ride. If you go back and look at it, there were some big things that were going on all across the board for those titles. Nice payoffs in a crazy way. But at any rate, there you go. There's my little silly, that's a romantic moment I remember. So first question, I mean, do you remember that one? Is it just me? Is there anybody else there that has a soft spot in their heart for the old New Mutants and that relationship? What are yours? What's the relationship you remember? What are the big moments that stand out in your mind and you know, make comics kind of the deep things that they are for you? Leave me a comment. Let me know. Love to hear. And subscribe if you haven't, and share with a friend if you wouldn't mind. And thanks for listening.